You can hear the blasts, but these Syrian children, unfazed. As some ride bikes playfully past storefronts, both shuttered and scarred, others calmly describe what they've seen. Once I saw a head fly by, says one. The first time we were afraid, says another boy. Now we're used to it. Then, a huge explosion nearby. They scramble to find safety. They're unharmed, at least not physically harmed. Later, one boy is asked if anyone taught him to dive to the ground the way he did. No, all by myself, he states proudly. Like so many other Syrian children, they learn about life and death far too soon, and all on their own. Countless futures have been destroyed. The circumstances so dire, there are now well more than 1 million child refugees. It's why the UN is sounding the alarm, releasing a new report urging the world to act in order to save, quote, traumatized, isolated, and suffering Syrian children from catastrophe. Close to 400,000 of them now live in neighboring Lebanon, if you can call this living. Huddling in the Bekaa Valley's makeshift camps, playing in Sidon's half-built schools, surviving wherever and however they can. The alienation and agony apparent. You see their suffering throughout the streets of the capital as well. I'm in the heart of Beirut's commercial district. In the past four blocks that I've walked, I've come across 10 Syrian children, all under the age of 7, begging alongside their mothers. Then there are the children trying to support their families. Many shine shoes. Several, like 12-year-old Ali, sell tissues. He tells me his home in Idlib was destroyed, that he's been in Lebanon for all of 3 days, that he, his mother, and sister have no other choice. I ask if he can go to school here. How am I going to go to school? He shoots back. Later, with startling directness, he says, I have to work. I have to make money. If I don't, how are we going to make it? Life doesn't get much harsher. And it's clear devastation comes in many forms for what is rapidly becoming a lost generation. Mohammed Jamjoum, CNN, Beirut.